WHO made the assessment that COVID-19 can be characterized as a pandemic.
Hey, morning.
Morning. Sawadee ka. Good morning. Right now we stay in Kanchanaburi.
So day three from the trip. Today we are going to see the Hellfire Pass, which plays a very important role in World War II. And near that Hellfire Pass, there is a cave which is used by Japanese soldiers. I don't know the exact history. I'll ask Stan about that. And from there, we'll take a train to River Kwai, and that's where we'll be staying for the night. Right now, I think like the hotel people have organized an ATV ride for me. So I'll take a quick ATV ride, then I'll go and have my breakfast, and then we'll head to the Hellfire Pass. So that was quite an adventurous ride. Like, I've never done ATV on my own. It has always been either I'm pillion or like somebody sitting behind when I'm driving. But this was the first time I drove it on my own. And initially I was a little scared, but yeah, that was really fun.
Hello. These are Thai pancakes.
So done with the lunch, done with the ATV ride, and now we'll head to the Hellfire Pass. I think we are a little late, but I'm sure we'll catch up. So we have just reached the Hellfire Pass. This is the parking area, this is not the pass. So we are going to walk till there, or we are going to take any ride? We are going to walk. So we are going to walk till the point where there is exact Hellfire Pass. So I've just made it to the Hellfire Pass, and there's a very interesting story attached with this pass. So basically, this is a railway track built from Thailand to Burma by all the prisoners from World War II. Like during World War II, when Japanese won the war, they had a lot of prisoners consisting of Britishers, Australians, people from Holland, and few laborers from Thailand as well. So they were building this track from Thailand to Burma, and they were very difficult weather condition at that time. Like, it used to be very hot and humid during the daytime, and it used to be super cold during night. And also, like, they were not given proper food, so it was very difficult for them. But after the bomb in Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the war got over and all the prisoners got released, and this pass never got completed. Like, it's still incomplete. And yeah, that's the story of this Hellfire Pass. It still looks very historic. I can see a lot of flags from England, there's flag of Australia, there's flag of America, Holland and Thailand. So basically these are all the people who were the laborers, and yeah, this is to give them respect. So this is the cave I was talking about. The name of the cave is Thum Kasai Cave. And the story of this cave is, after the end of World War II, all the Japanese soldiers over here, they committed suicide. It's also called as Karakiri. So they committed Karakiri over here. All of them died because everything for them was destroyed back home. So this is the place where they committed Karakiri, which is also known as suicide. So it's pretty interesting. So as you can see, the train has slowed down quite a lot because we will be crossing the wooden bridge now. So obviously, like, you cannot drive fast on the wooden bridge. But yeah, it's a very old bridge, and again, like, constructed during World War II. So interesting. So now we have reached the River Kwai bridge, and our hotel is somewhere nearby. So this is where we'll be put up for the night. I'm really excited to check into the hotel because it's kind of hot today and I'm generally feeling very hot. Alright, so it's evening right now, and now we are heading to check out the River Kwai Bridge. I'm not sure if I'll be able to fly a drone over there, but I'll try my best. But let's go and check out the place. How does it look like?
Like the flower blending into bliss, then with me. where it is.